Hello learners, greetings to all of you from UGC, HRDC, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. I am Professor Krishan Kapoor from Department of Bio and Nanotechnology, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. The title of this module is Mastering Academic Writing Skills. So the writing skills are an immensely important and powerful tool in the academic world. If you plan to stay in academics, it will be a defining feature of your academic life. Writing skills are used to communicate information in an appropriate and effective manner. Success with academic writing depends on how well you understand what you are doing and you write, and then how you approach the writing task. Good writing is a matter of achieving desired effect upon intended audience. Academic writing doesn't require unique talent or outstanding ability. Writing clearly and effectively is a valuable skill. Everyone has basic acumen to write and well, and this skill can be honed to get the desired results. Academic writing skills encompass strong composition, excellent grammar, and consistent stylistic approach. You need not to master English grammar in order to express yourself correctly and appropriately in academic context. Becoming an experienced writer in any field or discipline takes a great deal of practice. After completing this module, the learners will be able to understand the logic and structure of academic writing, identify the qualities that make academic writing effective, know what you write in every part of every section, streamline writing process to achieve a better write-up in less time. Academic writing differs from other types of writing, such as journalistic or creative writing. Informal language used between friends and on social networking sites generally is not appropriate in academic context. It is important to present your arguments in logical and manner to arrive at conclusions. Academic writing can take many forms. These include research articles, paper review articles, research reports, research project proposals for funding, dissertations or theses, textbooks, book chapters, dated books, and lab manuals. Different styles adhere to each of these types of academic writing. Writing involves starting, progressing, and finishing a complicated combination of tasks. Writing is not just influenced by what we know and what we have discovered about something, but also what we feel. Writing requires shaping your ideas in a story-like manner. Now, what makes a good writing? Good writing communicates an idea clearly and effectively. Academic writing skills encompass strong composition, grammar, and a consistent stylistic approach. Academic writing needs to be well-structured. It should have clear, logical paragraphs divided into clear sections and subsections. Writing to inform is a craft, not an art. Clear, effective writing can be learned. Clear writing starts with clear thinking. So once you know what you are trying to say, and then pay attention to your words. Now, attributes of a good writing. A good manuscript should be clear. It avoids unnecessary details. It should be simple, uses direct language, avoiding vague or complicated sentences. It should be impartial. It avoids making unproven statements. It presents how and where data were collected and supports its conclusion with evidences. Structured logically, ideas and processes are expressed in a logical order. The text is divided into sections with clear headings and subheadings. It should be accurate. It avoids vague and ambiguous statements, such as about, approximately, almost, etc. It has objective statements and ideas that are supported by appropriate evidences that demonstrate how conclusions have been drawn, as well as acknowledging the work of others. It should be free from grammatically and stylistic errors, recognizing contribution of others, and technically correct. The writing process. The writing process can be split into stages: planning for writing, writing the first draft, revising, finishing touch or editing. Now, the planning process. Planning is necessary with all academic writing. Planning for writing has been identified as one of the key practices for good writers. Make time to write. If possible, set aside a specific time for each day. Start to write early and do not postpone, as there is never a perfect time. Try to find a time and place where you can think and write without distractions. Don't aim for perfection on the first draft. Let it flow and then come back to polish it. Start by reading what you have produced so far and spend a bit of time rephrasing things. Make a note of structure of the text you want to write and list the main headings. Do not stop to correct and revise. Keep going and then come back to do this at a later stage. Hastily written papers get rejected. Papers are like mine. They need time to mature. Read critically and draw relevant material from scholarly texts to craft your academic writing. When reading and gathering information in academic context, evidence comes from primary and published resources. Primary evidence is the raw data such as questionnaires, interviews, focus groups or experiments that are used by a researcher to gather data to answer a specific research questions. So they provide proof for insight in regard to the topic or question. Published resources constitute the literature on the topic such as books, journals, reports. In the journals, published resources from peer-reviewed journals carry most weight. It is important to read appropriate peer-reviewed journals in your literature when planning your academic writing. In academic writing, you will almost always draw on the work of others. Knowing who to reference is the key. There are a variety of referencing systems, but in all systems, the source is cited in the text with a number or name. So, writing the first draft. Because academic paper should have a clear organizational structure, throughout your paper, you need to show the readers whose ideas are connected between paragraphs and between sentences. Your first draft is complete, but your paper is far from finished. The next step is to revise your paper, strengthen the content. So start this at least a week before your paper is due. In fact, you don't need to wait until you have complete first draft to start revising. You can revise individual paragraphs as you finish them as well. Get your paper read by as many friendly people as possible. If there is time, revise your second draft and keep revising. Good writers actually tend to revise more rather than less as they gain more writing experience. Express you in your own way will help you to say what you mean, and if your reader can hear your voice, reading will be easier. Don't try to get it right first time. Resist the temptation to edit as you go. You will tend to get stuck and waste time unnecessarily. Now the revision process. Although it is tempting to think that the first draft of an essay is adequate, it is almost certain that it can be improved subsequently. After completing your first draft, you should leave it for a day and then reread it. Use measures and quantities when possible. Say how fast or slow, or something is good, bad, unusual or interesting. Make sure the reader understands clearly what is meant by these statements. When possible, use concrete words that will build pictures in the reader's mind. Don't ponder over words. Keep going. Leave gaps. If necessary, aim for natural flow. Express you in your own way. It will help you to say what you mean more exactly. If your reader can hear your voice, reading will be easier. Don't try to get it right for the first time. Resist the temptation to edit as you go. You will tend to get stuck and waste time unnecessarily. Now, the finishing touch, or you can say editing strategies. Read the beginning and end of every paragraph to make sure that they flow together. Limit each paragraph to a single message. Each paragraph should explore the message by first asking a question and then progressing to an idea and sometime to an answer. It is also perfectly fine to raise questions in a paragraph and leave them unanswered. Go through the paper sentence by sentence and then find connections between them. Keep sentence short, simply constructed and direct. Concise, clear sentences work well for scientific explanations. Minimize clauses, compound sentences and transition words such as however or thus. so that the reader can focus on main message. Read each sentence. Each one ask, is it necessary to the paragraph? Does it add something new? Could it be eliminated completely or partially? Could it be a combination of sentences? Read each sentence word by word. Is every word necessary? Could some be eliminated or rewritten in a clear way? Could passive verbs be written as active ones? Read the first 5 words of each sentence to find sentences starting in the same way. Change your sentences to find a variety. Look at the length of the each sentence. There should be a variety of short and long sentences. Make sentences shorter by dividing them or longer by combining. Find words which are repeated a lot. Use a thesaurus to find other words to use. Go through the essay sentence by sentence. Label the subjects and verbs in every sentence. Make sure each sentence has a subject and a verb. Find all the long words. Could some be replaced with shorter, clearer words? Read your paper without using a lot of effort. You are just reading because you are interested in the topic. When you think your paper is ready to turn it, it is time to check for mistakes. Don't look at your paper for at least 24 hours. Print your paper, you will see mistakes that you might not see on a computer screen. Point your pen at each word. Think about the grammar, spelling, punctuation, capitalization, and meaning of each word. If you are sure about everything, use a dictionary or grammar book. If you are still unsure, make the line and ask someone for help. Fix any mistakes that are found. Now, avoiding plagiarism. Basically, plagiarism means taking ideas or words from a source without giving credit to the author. It is seen as a kind of theft and is considered to be an academic crime. In academic work, ideas and words are seen as private property belonging to a person who first thought or wrote them. If you borrow them or refer to the work of other person, you must show that you have done this by borrowing the correct acknowledgement. When you use a source of your paper, give credit when it is due. Acknowledge the author of the original work. Use your own work as often as possible. Quote and or cite your sources properly. Use plagiarism check softwares which are available at your institute. The in-text citation should be linked to a list of references at the end of the main text. Quotation should not be overused. So you must learn to paraphrase and summarize in order to include other writers' ideas in your work. This will demonstrate your understanding of a text. Paraphrasing involves rewriting a text so that language is substantially different from the context. Summarizing means reducing the length of the text but retaining the main points. So now to conclude, good writing is an important skill that is critical to academic writing. Academic writing skills encompass strong composition, excellent grammar, and a consistent stylistic approach. Becoming an experienced writer in any field of discipline takes a great deal of practice, practice, and practice. Thank you for your kind attention.